Everyone, today we are going to solve one example on prestressed concrete beam. So in this example, we'll be calculating resultant stress. Coming to this example, so a concrete beam is given. Its width is 150 mm and depth is 300 mm. In this beam, 8 wires are located at bottom, so it which is 100 mm from the bottom fibers, and 2 wires of 6 mm diameter is located at top, which is 25 mm from top. If you see, this is the beam, 150 width, depth is 300 mm, 8 wires are placed 100 mm from bottom and 2 wires of 6 mm diameter, 25 mm from top. The pre-stress is 1250 Newton per mm square. Calculate the stresses at top and bottom fibers of the mid-span section. When the beam is supporting its own weight, over a span of 7.5 meter and live load of 3 kN per meter is imposed. So first we are going to calculate distance of pre-stressing force from the base. From here, how much is the distance? So this formula is area into y by summation of area. So coming to this, area of this wires are 8 numbers into area is pi by 4 d square. So pi by 4, diameter of this wires are 5 mm into the distance from the base is 100 mm plus these are 2 wires. Distance will be 300 minus 25, 275 and pi by 4 d square. Here diameter is 6 by summation of area. So 8 into pi by 4 d square for the this where numbers are 8 and diameter is 5. Here numbers are 2 and diameter is 6. So we got 146.32 mm or we can say 0.146 meter. So this is the distance from bottom, because from base we are calculating from here to this. So now what is the eccentricity? Total center line of the beam will be here at 150. So minus this distance, this is the eccentricity. So E is 150 minus 146.32 is 3.68 mm. This is the eccentricity of pre-stressing force. Now we are going to calculate pre-stressing force is the stress that is given 1250 into total area of the steel. So pi by 4 d square into 8 numbers and 2 numbers of 6 dia bar. So total area of the steel into the stress. So we'll get the force. Stress into area is force. So we got 267 kN of pre-stressing force. What is the total load? Dead load plus live load. So dead load is 25 unit weight into the area of cross section, 0.15 into 0.3. So 150 in meter I have done, because this is 25 kilonewton per meter cube, this unit is. So I have made this, converted the cross section in meter. So 0.15 into 0.3 plus 3 kilonewton per meter live load. It is given in the question that 3 kilonewton per meter of live load is imposed. So plus total is 4.125 kilonewton per meter. Then coming to total moment, that means moment due to dead load plus live load is WL square by 8, because in the question it is given we have to calculate the stress at mid-span. So mid-span means if bending moment, WL square by 8 will be the mid-span moment. If it is a simply supported, the maximum moment will be at mid-span, which is WL square by 8. So load is 4.125, span is given in the question 7.5. So WL square by 8 is 29 kilometer meter. Then coming to section modulus Z, here top and bottom are same, because that means the Z is I by Y, moment of inertia will be same, BDQ by 12, and Y is the distance of centroid from top and distance of center from bottom for the corresponding top and bottom fibers. So because it is same, because this is a rectangular section, if it would have been I or T section, then Y would have been different. But for this case, it's a simple rectangular, centroids at center. So we are having D by 2, the distance of centroid from the top fiber. So BD square by 6, B is 150, D is 300 by 6. Okay, BD square by 6, we got section modulus value. Now coming to resultant stress at top fiber. So the formula is P by A minus PE by Z plus M by Z. P we have calculated, 267 kilonewton meter. P is this 267 kilonewton. So this kilonewton I am converting to newton, because area I have taken in mm. So 267 into 1000 by 150 into 300 minus P is 267 into 1000. This in Newton into 3.68 is our eccentricity by Z value. We have calculated 2.256 plus moment is 29 kilonewton meter. So 2 Newton. So you see 29 kilonewton meter. I'm going to convert this into Newton mm. So into 10 to the 6 by Z. So we got 18.38 Newton per mm square at top fiber. So resultant stress at bottom fiber. So this both are for mid span section because we are taking moment 29 kilonewton meter at mid span. 5.93. So same values. The only thing is here we have to do plus and here minus. At bottom it is tensile and this will be compressive. So we got minus 6.523 Newton per mm square. So this is this much compression and this is this much tension. So these are the resultant stresses at top and bottom fibers. So this is for this example. Thank you for watching.